So you want to learn how to lose body fat, lose weight, but you are tired of tracking calories. You're tired of living on MyFitnessPal, from what I hear. And that's fine. Before we get started, though, I want to kind of teach you something. I want you to remind you of something, and that is what you don't know, you can't improve upon. So let me give you an example. If you and I have a teacher and student relationship, and you're the teacher, I'm the student, and I come to you and I say, hey, I failed your math test. Why'd I fail your math test? And all I have on that piece of paper is a bunch of answers. You're not gonna be able to tell me what I did wrong. All you're gonna be able to say is, oh, you didn't show your work. But if I come to you and I say, this is what I did, and I failed, why'd I fail? You can look at it and say, oh, well, you keep multiplying instead of dividing. So you need to divide here, here, and here. And then I can go back and I can fix it and I can do better next time. So same thing with food logging. If you're not food logging, if you don't want a food log, understand that you're losing that metric. And if things aren't working for you, we have nothing to look at to try to figure out why. But if you're still hell-bent on not tracking, you can still lose body fat really easily and really efficiently by doing what I call the metabolism on fire method. Now I'm gonna teach you a little bit about what that is in this video. The first part of that metabolism on fire method is getting your body to burn body fat as often as it possibly can, preferably all day long. The only way to do that is to teach it that it doesn't always need to rely on the food that you're eating. And how we do that is by intermittent fasting. So pushing your breakfast back not only has shown to clear up skin, make you live a little bit longer, give you more mental clarity, give you more sustainable energy, balance out your hormones, balance out your blood sugar, reduce insulin resistance, improve insulin sensitivity, all these different things, but it also is teaching your body that you don't always have to burn the energy that you're eating, you are allowed to burn the energy that you're storing, which is body fat. Now, from there, we wanna go to step two, which is focusing on holistic, good quality, nutrient-dense foods. Look, you cannot not track food and still eat a bunch of total garbage. It's going to work against you. But if you eat really a nutrient-dense food and focus on good quality sources, good things are gonna happen for you. And how we do that is we scrap all processed sugars, we get rid of all the nonsense, we get rid of all the fizzy drinks, all the drinks except water, and maybe a little bit of coffee. And then we focus on all fresh foods. We want as many fresh foods as we possibly can. So get rid of all boxed foods, get rid of fast food, all of those different things. What that will do is it'll blow your metabolism way out of the water and really start leveraging your own systems to work for you so you can burn body fat all day long. And then step number three is to make sure you're pulling from different food sources within those macronutrients. So if you have proteins, don't just always eat chicken. Eat a little bit of chicken, eat a little bit of steak, eat a little bit of fish, you know, whatnot. Eat whatever you want from those fresh sources that are protein dominant. Now, if you don't know what protein dominant foods are, then we have to go back to the beginning and you need to ask me and I can send you a list. But if you do know what those things are, then you can pull from different sources within that protein macronutrient. Same thing with your carbohydrates. If you have carbohydrates as the overall, you know, umbrella, what carbohydrates do you want to pull from and then pull from different sources? A little bit of fruits, a little bit of grains, maybe a little bit of sweet potatoes, maybe a little bit of normal potatoes, a little bit of rice, you know, whatnot. And then do the same thing with fats. A little bit of avocado maybe, a little bit of nuts, a little bit of oil, different types of oil, right? Coconut oil, olive oil, things like that. Now, if you're pulling from different sources, you're getting different vitamins and minerals from all of those different sources, and you're doubling down because they're really fresh, really nutrient-dense, good quality foods. It's very difficult to overeat eating really nutrient-dense, low-calorie foods. Because if you take a look at maybe Mandarin chicken from, like, I don't know, Panda Express, it has almost double the amount of calories that you could put into your own chicken, your own Mandarin chicken, if you just made Mandarin chicken at home. So you're gonna end up eating less calories by eating fresher, foods that you're eating from your own home rather than going somewhere else where they cook it for you, even though it's fresh. So cook from your house, cook nutrient-dense food, and then make sure that you intermittent fast to promote your body to burn body fat all the time, and make sure that you're pulling from different sources within those macronutrients. And those are a few things that I teach in my Metabolism on Fire method, which is part of my coaching programs. So if you want to learn more about that, you can always let me know. You can always just reach out to me. But for the most part, if you want to start moving away from counting calories all the time, then you need to start focusing on building a metabolism that's going to work for you, which is something that I teach heavily. So if you want to learn more, then you can reach out to me. But in the meantime, start working on those three. Those are the first few steps to building a metabolism that's constantly on fire. So I love you. I hope this helps, and I'll see you in the next one.